Yeah, we don't want to do anything to scare your children. That's the last thing we want to do. We don't want to scare anybody.
Good evening. Welcome to our unrehearsed, spontaneous, and informal program. As always, no teleprompters, no cue cards, no idiot boards, no reruns. Just plain ad-lib conversation in which we try and tell it like it really is.
Filming?
No, I was filming earlier. I missed whatever the big ruckus was. My other reporter is here and got it all, though, Andy Lee.
Yeah, man.
And anyways, I was down there the other day, and this leftist commie, you know, like the ones you and Alexa was over there, one of them son of a bitches come by in a wheelchair, started calling us all bitches and holes and shit. So what I did is I was filming her, you know, and whatnot.
Yeah, yeah.
And then the cop said he's in a fucking, he goes like that to cut filming.
Oh,
and I said, no, I'm with the media, you know, I'm going to do that.
Yeah, you're with the media.
Yeah, and then he said he's going to bust, if I don't stop, he's going to bust the fucking camera over my head. I got the film right there. That's crazy, man.
Put that up on the internet.
Did you ever apply for your independent press gallery yet?
I did not, sir.
Oh, man, you need to do it because you guys, live streamers are wonderful, and you're just an important part of the media. As, you know, I believe, I'm like Charlie Duff, I believe, like me and you, and, you know, and Viva Frey, we're out here with the people. That's where you need to be. The story is more with the people than it is the politicians. When you do that, you're just a stenographer for whatever they blow out their mouth, you know?
Yeah. You're just copying down what they're saying. Yeah, you're a stenographer, yeah.
Yeah, and here, being a reporter and a journalist puts her stuff on the paper, you know that.
Right.
And, you know, that's a journalist. A reporter, a real reporter, you know, they're either a broadcast commentator like you, but you're a reporter, you're not so much a journalist, you don't write that much anymore. But you're a good broadcast commentator. I listen to you, everything you put up, man.
Wow, well, thank you, sir. Really appreciate it, man. Let me take a look at this press pass right over here.
That's independent press gallery, you know, Candace Malcolm. She's wonderful. So is Andrew Watton.
Hey, you're the man, Vincent. You're the man, brother.
Yeah, I try, buddy. I try.
Well, it's working. Keep doing what you're doing, man.
Thank God you didn't bring your kids down here to see that ruckus. You know, all it takes is one.
I know, right?
I told the one guy yesterday, don't get up in the police's face. You know, don't engage with them at all unless you got to defend your rights, you know. And he's over to the police, and that's, you know, no.
He got himself
locked up.
Yeah, yeah.
Ryan, he almost got locked up the other day. Or actually, he did.
Yeah.
You know him, Ro? He's the last trucker standing on the hill, Ro.
Is he? Oh, this is the last. Oh, he's the last one.
Yeah, like Bruce Willis.
I hear about it. Yeah. Last Man Standing.
Well, here's the thing.
That's a great movie, man.
Yeah,
I love that movie.
That's my video about him too.
Oh yeah.
Well, here's the thing.
Cool.
You gotta understand, there's a little bit of an anomaly going on here.
You know who that is?
The protest hasn't ended. The protest never ended. It started on January 29th, and it never hasn't stopped.
And it will
That's
not,
what they need
win.
To understand.
You're the man, brother. I love it, man.
You want to go get something to eat with us?
No, I got.
I'm gonna go get a Donair a little later.
I'm gonna go treat my treat.
What are you eating, Vincent?
I had a hot dog at Biker's Church. I don't know. I'll get something.
Yeah, all right.
Well, you want to get a Donair?
Maybe a little later on. I'm gonna see what's going on. There's Scott over here. This guy actually sued Ottawa councilwoman because she wouldn't take the mask off the kids. And he did a good job, man. He sent that letter the whole bit. Went through it, put the pressure on him. You know what I mean? Turned the screws. That's what it's about, brother.
You live streaming right now?
Yeah, man.
Okay, good. You know, live streamers, people don't understand that they're just as important part of the press as, you know, as journalists. The CBC ran from me again today.
Did they?
Yeah.
I'm not surprised.
I don't know how to hug this guy with all his stuff, but he's got a side thing that he's going,
right?
He's doing.
Oh, umbrella and everything, man. You're
like
so ready.
I have to be, man. I was born ready. What are you up to, brother?
Oh, I thought maybe you had something in your beard you could do for an umbrella.
Yeah, I should get one.
I'm exhausted, man. Did you march in with all your stuff? Yeah, you did. I saw you really.
No, well, you know what, man? I mean, I'm, put it this way, I'm not at the healthiest that I've been over the last 3 years.
Really?
But I'm working on it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you're doing your push-ups?
No, I'm doing my sit-up from my chair and go to the kitchen to grab a beer.
Oh, are you serious? No, you've been working on stuff. You're trying to make yourself a better person, right? Like you talked about that before, right?
Yeah.
And that kind of inspired
me as well.
I got to
do a little more, though.
Yeah, well, we can all do
a little
more.
You know what I mean?
I know.
Got to do a little more, brother.
Yeah.
How about you? How are you doing?
I've been doing my push-ups, man.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm trying to, like, get solid, you know?
And, you look good. You're
thank
tough.
You, brother.
Yeah, you're looking great. Man.
I look a lot better than I did, you know, before the trucker, because I went through like depression for a long time.
That's
not
I mean.
A depression, just a lack of motive, lack of vision, lack of motivation.
It's not depression. It's just basically a malaise where you're not eating properly, you're not sleeping properly, you're not taking care of yourself.
Weed,
I know, entertaining myself.
I know.
Masturbation.
Know,
I know, bro.
Sex,
pornography.
And
then you got your wife.
I got
your girlfriend. Yeah, I know.
Yeah, I had nothing to like.
Right now, what I say is, babe, stay away from me because I'm a monk. All right? I'm a monk. I need to save my seed so that I can stand up tall. Because every time you come and you put your lady charms on me, I can't think straight. I'm just teasing.
Put you in that spell,
I'm just teasing. Nah, she's good.
I'll be honest with you, though. You did mention something about that in one of your posts. I was like, you know what? I'm going to try to, like, not, you know?
I know.
I lasted about a week.
Yeah.
I'm like, you know, I'm
1 week without.
I'm like, I'm 47, right?
Yeah, man.
I'm like, you know what? It was fine.
Sure.
It was good. But I'm like, I started thinking, like, you know what? If I don't use it,
you might lose it.
I might lose it. And so I'm like, you know what? I better go back to, because it's, you know, it puts me to sleep at night, you know?
It's a medicine.
We're streaming, you know, right?
Are you?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Come on.
Is that live? Are you kidding?
I'm one of your casts where he's talking about government funding and everything. I got some good input for you right here. Yeah, when we have it on there, I'll tell you about it. And then you can put it in there. You ever see that Glenn Beck special who runs the Biden administration?
Yeah.
Same thing. Okay, this Hans George Weiss's place. It's a the Nature Conservancy. Go down there at 350 Sparks. It looks like Saddam Hussein's palace. They can fund billions of dollars through the back
door. Money is just pouring
in.
Right?
And they way more than what the conservatives get. So he used that to stack the Senate, stack the parliament,
of course,
and everything. And then what do they do when they win? They give the money right back to him in funding. It's like a big money orgy.
Oh, yeah. It's a money orgy. That's a good way to put it.
Yeah, exactly. Watch that Glenn Beck special. All those organizations demand just everything. It's operating here in Canada.
Well, look over here. We got an anti-hate group. They call it an anti-hate group.
Yeah,
these guys,
all about hate. You ever
exactly.
See a reporter, Andy Lee's thing on that?
No, I got to watch it.
Okay.
Oh, yeah,
just
eh?
Give me your email and I'll email you.
Yeah. You got a pencil and a paper or a phone?
No.
Or let me send you an email from my thing.
Yeah, it's 709.
Hold on a second here.
Mine is VNACAN.
One second here. All right, yeah. All
right. VNA.
VNA.
CAN.
Yep.
USA@gmail.com. And I'll send you some good stuff, buddy. You know, we don't have an audience like you do in Canada. You lucked out by being at the right place at the right time at the convoy. They're like, you know, Dave driving the shit. I've been doing this 30 years, buddy.
No, I know, man. I mean, you're the real deal, man. We're, you know what, we're just pretenders and just playing at it. You know what I mean?
Like I said, you're just as important part of the media.
We're just, you know what I mean? We just dudes picking up a camera because we're pissed off.
Like when I was 6 years old, you know, the age younger than your kids, I was out there with my mother with an old 16 mil, you know.
No, you've been doing the real shit, Vince. And the bottom line is, you've been doing the real stuff over here. Everybody out there can learn a little something. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's called the benefit experience.
When I was 6 years old, I was in the riots in Detroit with my mother. Well, she was covering it for Lou Gordon.
See that?
And the National Guard were shooting and everything. This was nothing but a bunch of kids in bouncy castles that acted like it was the most violent thing in the world.
Crazy.
They're idiots, man.
Crazy. Crazy.
Yeah, if you want to have a Donaire, I'll turn you. Watch that Glenn Beck special. Everything that he's saying in that thing, all those organizations are right here in Canada. 350 Sparks, the Imperial Building on Bank Street. The one day you passed right by it, you didn't know that was a Soros stronghold. And now they hit all, like when Key and Bexty went into the one in Toronto, the Toronto cone of it,
yeah.
You know, Dominion thing, they hid the Tides Foundation name and everything's there on Bank Street.
You're going to have to give me the lowdown.
Yeah, and I'll take you in there. The whole 7th floor is empty. There's supposed to be 250 organizations in there.
I'm going to walk around, film a little bit more, Vincent, and then if you're still here, we'll go and grab a bite to eat.
Yeah, I'll wait around for you then.
Yeah, all right.
I've been meaning to talk to you. I talk to Viva all the time. Me and him hang out together when he's here.
Yeah, no, you don't,
in
huh?
New York now.
Maybe we'll even need a donor on cam. What do you think, Patrick?
What I'd like you to do is, if you can, say, you know, a group that needs a reporter, you know, because I need a reporter. I'm getting too old with this one disabled arm I got hurt in the military, right?
Right.
And like Neil even said, that's a flag off my father's casket, eh? And Neil said, so good to see you brought that. He knew exactly what it was. That's a U.S. issue flag.
Yeah. You know what I'm going to do, Vincent? Actually, tonight, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get some rest because I'm going to wake up early tomorrow morning, 7. So let's. You're here in Ottawa for a bit?
Yeah, I'm stationed here.
Okay, so how about this? You send me a reply to that email.
Okay.
And then we'll set something up. And that's the day we'll do it. Because tonight, what I'm going to do is...
you've got a big audience. Well, you lucked out, buddy.
Yeah. Well, yeah,
Annalise World lucked out, too. And I know Ray real good. They got married in my church. Hey?
Oh, yeah.
I've been going to biker church since they started. You should stop in there every once in a while.
Maybe I should.
Yeah.
I might bring my kids down there.
Yeah, it's a good environment. Yeah. They got a kid's place in the bottom where they play. Yeah. They make airplanes, you know. Yeah. They watch movies and everything. It's good. It's Christian, but it's good.
Yeah, I'm good with that, man. Yeah. I mean, I love Christianity.
Even Viva, you know I mean? I told him he was going to go to a barbecue once, and he, you know.
Mm.
You know.
Yeah, cool.
Viva's awesome, man.
Yeah, he's a good dude, man. Very intelligent,
Did you hear? Yeah, I went to law school, too. When Charlie LeDuff was going to University of Michigan, I went, too, but I went to a different thing than him. When Viva was there that Saturday morning, Rolling Thunder, did you hear his little spiel against Trudeau? Oh, my God. It's so good, yeah.
Really, huh?
Yeah, he's sitting there on the bench telling... Like, I just was walking down Rideau Street, he says, and there's people lying with needles in their own arms and lying in their own piss, and the government can spend billions of dollars on vaccine passports, but they can't help the people lying in the street.
Good dude, Vincent, man. Good guy. Hail, brethren. All right, let me find a garbage.
Very cool.
Yeah, man. Very, you know what? Old school, real journalist. Like, real... You know what I mean? Like, there's... Okay, you heard of a spring chicken, right? And then there's...
Right.
Yeah, then you know when you get like an old chicken and the bones, when you make broth out of an old chicken? And that, it's like next level. Because there's so much experience distilled in those bones.
Just breaks right in through the years.
Yeah, man. And that's Vincent. He's got heavy-duty experience. You don't get that normally. You just don't.
Rodney's old school, like, you know, pre-social media and all that.